वेलकम फ्रेंड्स, लेट्स डिस्कस बफर सॉल्यूशंस, लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव्स. स्टूडेंट्स शुड एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड टाइप्स ऑफ बफर्स, देन बफर एक्शन, बफर इक्वेशन, बफर कैपेसिटी एंड बफर एप्लीकेशंस. नाउ विल डिस्कस वन बाय वन. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल विल डिस्कस टाइप्स ऑफ बफर्स. नाउ बेसिकली द फार्मास्यूटिकल बफर और बफर सॉल्यूशंस आर क्लासिफाइड इनटू थ्री सब टाइप्स. फर्स्ट वन इज एसिडिक बफर्स, देन बेसिक बफर्स एंड फॉस्फेट बफर्स और एम्फोटेरिक बफर्स. नाउ विल डिस्कस वन बाय वन. एसिडिक बफर मीन्स इज अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ वीक एसिड एंड इट्स साल्ट विथ स्ट्रॉन्ग बेस. इट इज अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ थ्री थिंग्स. वन विल बी योर वीक एसिड, देन सेकेंड इट्स साल्ट ऑफ दैट वीक एसिड एंड थर्ड विल बी स्ट्रॉन्ग बेस. देन देर इज अ फॉर्मुलेशन ऑफ एसिडिक बफर्स. Weak acid, salt plus salt with strong base or conjugate base. Example of this acidic buffers: CH3COOH and CH3COONA. Then H2CO3 and NaHCO3. Then H3PO4 and NaH2PO4. These are different examples of acidic buffers. Then HCOOH and HCOONA. Now second part of this or second types of the buffer solution is nothing but basic buffers. And these basic buffers or buffer solution is combination of weak base and its salt with strong acid. That is weak base and salt with conjugate acid or strong acid will give you basic buffer. Now we'll see example of these basic buffers: NH4OH and NH4Cl. Then ammonia plus ammonium chloride is there. Then ammonia and ammonium carbonate, then third type is phosphate buffer. Beside these two general types, the buffer that is acidic and basic, a third appears to exist, and this buffer is composed of two salts: monobasic potassium phosphate and dibasic potassium phosphate. Then we'll see buffer action. Now this buffer action is resistance of buffer solution to change in pH is known as buffer action. How they resist to change? Depending on the mechanism of resistance is there. Now we'll see mechanism of action of acidic buffers. Consider that CH3COOH as a weak electrolyte and CH3COONA as a strong electrolyte, and there will be a large concentration of sodium ion and CH3COO minus ion and undissociated CH3COOH molecules in this buffer. When acid is added in this acidic buffer, if strong acid is added in these CH3COOH and CH3COONA buffer, that is acetic acid and sodium acetate, the change that will occur may be represented as okay, when you add acid in this system, the hydrogen ion in this acid immediately interact with this CH3COO minus and nullify effect of that acid. Hydrogen ion yielded by this HCl are quickly removed as unionized acetic acid, and hydrogen ion concentration is therefore only slightly affected because acetic acid produced a very weak as compared to the HCl added. So the H plus ion released from this HCl easily removed when they are interacting with this CH3COO group, that is dissociated form of your acetic acid. When base is added in this buffer, acidic buffer, acetic acid and sodium acetate, what happen? H plus ions, which is a dissociated form of acetic acid, immediately interact with your OH minus group, and removal of water molecule is there during this action and nullify effect of your base. Okay, hydroxyl ion yielded by NaOH are therefore removed as a water, and supply of hydrogen ion needed for this purpose being constantly provided by dissociation of acetic acid. Means there is a continuous dissociation of acetic acid and nullify effect of your alkali. This is a summary for the acetic acid buffer. Sodium acetate dissociate, and when you add H plus ion, the dissociated form of CH3COH interact with H plus ion, and acetic acid dissociate and it generates H plus ion that react with this OH minus, and likewise we can nullify effect of addition of small amount of acid and alkali by using this acidic buffer. Then second type, that is basic, second mechanism, that is mechanism of action of basic buffer. Ammonium hydroxide and ammonium chloride is a composition in this buffer system. Ammonium hydroxide acts as a weak electrolyte and NH4Cl acts as a strong electrolyte. So combinedly they are resisting change in pH. There will be a large concentration of NH4+ ion and Cl- ion and undissociated NH4OH molecules. Now this NH4 dissociated as NH4+ and OH-, and when you add acid in this system, that H plus ion of acid interact with this OH- ion of base and nullify effect of that acid. So it try to keep hydrogen ion concentration of system constant, and there is no change in the pH of your formulation. And this OH minus are continuously provided with the help of NH4OH . Now this is all about the addition of base into this basic buffer, how they are nullifying effect of your acid when you add acid into this basic buffer. Now we'll see, when you add a small amount of base in this buffer, that is basic buffer, what happen? NH4Cl, okay, NH4Cl dissociate at Cl minus and NH4+. Now this NH4+ react with this OH- and nullify effect of alkali. and NH4OH is removed from the system. Then action of phosphate buffer, that is potassium dihydrogen phosphate and dipotassium hydrogen phosphate, it acts as a phosphate buffer. Then there is K2HPO4 dissociated as KH2PO4 dissociated as H2PO4- minus and serve as a weak acid, and HPO4- serve as a conjugate base. Then this HPO4- interact with hydronium ion or hydrogen ion and nullify its effect. Okay, this hydrogen ion or hydronium ion are there when you add acid in your solution. Then this HPO4- which acts as a weak acid, they interact with hydroxyl ion or OH- ion and convert it into the water molecule and nullify effect of that particular alkali. This H2PO4 is dissociated from KH2PO4, while this HPO4- is dissociated from K2HPO4, and both are helpful to nullify effect of acid and bases. One by one, H2PO4- help to nullify effect of your hydronium ion and conjugate base obtained from K2HPO4 help to nullify effect of hydroxyl ion. Then we'll see buffer equation. For acidic buffer, pH of acid buffer can be calculated from dissociation constant. That dissociation constant is denoted as Ka of weak acid and concentration of acid and salt used. Dissociation expression of weak acid can be represented as Ha is acid and it is dissociated as H plus and A minus. Then dissociation constant will be H plus into A minus divided by Ha, or H plus is equal to Ka into Ha divided by A minus. This is your equation 1. A weak acid is only slightly dissociate, and its dissociation is further depressed by addition of salt like Xa, which provide ions. As a result, the equilibrium concentration of unionized acid is nearly equal to initial concentration of acid, and the equilibrium concentration of this A minus is assumed to be equal to initial concentration of salt added, since it is completely dissociated. Therefore, in above equation 1, we represent concentration of A minus by salt concentration. So we can replace this as a Ha as acid and as A minus as a salt. So your equation 1 will become H plus is equal to Ka into acid divided by salt. By taking a log from both sides, equation will become log H plus is equal to log Ka plus log of acid plus acid divided by salt. Then multiplying both sides with a negative sign, then final equation will become negative log of H plus ion is equal to negative log K minus log of acid divided by salt. So negative log or minus log of H plus is equal to pH, and log Ka is equal to pKa. So this equation will become pH instead of negative or minus log H plus, we can put pH. So here we can put pH, then instead of minus log K we can put pKa. So this equation will become pH is equal to pKa plus log of salt upon acid. And this equation is known as a Henderson-Hasselbalch equation for calculation of pH of acid. It helps to calculate pH value of buffer solution if concentration of acid as well as that of salt are known. Then for basic buffer, equation for basic buffer can be calculated in the same way as that of your acidic buffer. Consider a basic buffer composed of mixture of weak base, that is BOH, and its salt BA. Then after dissociation of this base, we can write BOH is equal to B plus and OH minus. So your dissociation constant of base will become B plus OH minus divided by BOH, or we can write it as OH minus is equal to KB into BOH divided by B plus. Now BOH is nothing but your base. A weak base is only slightly dissociated, and its dissociation is further depressed by addition of salt, which provides B plus ion. As a result, the equilibrium concentration of unionized base is nearly equal to initial concentration of your base. And the equilibrium concentration of B plus is assumed to be the initial concentration of salt added since it is completely dissociated. Means this B plus represent salt concentration. How much entities of B plus are there? That entities represents amount of salt added into this solution. Therefore, in above equation 1, we can represent concentration of B plus by salt concentration. So we can write it as OH minus is equal to KB divided into base divided by salt. Similarly, we can, as that of our acidic buffer, we can take a log of both side, then it will become log OH minus is equal to log KB plus log base log of base divided by salt, then multiplied both side with negative sign, then it will become negative log of OH minus, then minus log KB minus log base upon salt. Now as we know, negative log of OH minus is equal to POH value, and negative log of KB is equal to PKB. Here just you have to put these values in your above equation, then equation will become POH is equal to PKB plus log of salt divided by base. By using this equation, you can determine a pH of your basic solution. By this equation, pH of buffer solution can be calculated from initial concentration of weak acid and salt provided when Ka is given. Henderson-Hasselbalch equation for basic buffer will give pOH and pH and can be calculated as pKw is equal to pH plus pOH, or pH is equal to pKw minus pOH. But value of this pKw is nothing but 14, so pH plus pOH is equal to 14. Then dissociation constant of weak acid is pKa and weak base is pKb, and they can be calculated by measuring pH of buffer solution containing equimolar concentration of acid and salt. Likewise, by using this Henderson-Hasselbalch equation for acidic and basic solution, we can determine pH. Now we'll move toward the next point, that is buffer capacity. Buffer capacity is a measure of its magnitude of its resistance to change in pH on addition of an acid or base. It is also referred as buffer index or buffer value or buffer efficiency or buffer coefficient. It is represented by sign beta, and it is also defined as the ratio of increment of strong acid or base to small change in pH brought about by this addition. Beta is equal to delta A or delta B or delta pH, where delta A and delta B represent small increment to the buffer to bring about pH change, and represented by delta pH is how much amount of acid you can add, or how much on addition of how much amount of acid that buffer can resist change in pH. It is known as the buffer capacity. According to the above equation, a solution has buffer capacity of 1 when 1 liter of it require 1 gram of equivalent of strong acid or strong base to change pH by unit 1. So, a smaller the pH change in the solution upon addition of acid or base, greater is its buffer capacity. Means when small change in pH is there, then you can say that that particular buffer is having a very good capacity to resist that change. And if more change is there into the pH, or if delta pH value is more, then we can say that buffer capacity is less. Then prepare a buffer solution of pH 5 from acetic acid, where the acetic acid is having a pKa value 4.7. Then required pH is 5 and pKa is 4.7. So molar concentration of acid required 1 mole. Molar concentration of base required x mole. So we require to calculate molar concentration of base. So by putting above information in equation, we can get pH is equal to pKa plus log of salt upon acid. pH is 5, pKa is 4.7, so we don't know molar concentration of base or salt, so we can put x here, and molar concentration for the acid is 1, so we can put this value in this equation. Then by simplifying this equation we'll get minus 4.7 is equal to log x minus log 1, but log 1 value is 0, so 0.3 is equal to log x, so x is equal to log raised to minus 0.3, and x will become you have to take anti log of this value, and then value of your x will become 2. So in this way, when you mix your acetic acid and sodium acetate into 1:2 ratio, then we'll get pH of final solution 5. So likewise we can calculate pH of solution. Now we'll see applications of these buffers. First of all, we'll discuss in this biological system. Blood is having pH 7.4. By two buffer systems are working in our body, that are primary buffers, and that present in the plasma, and plasma contains this carbonic acid and carbonates, and acid or alkali, sodium salt or phosphoric acid, and they are helpful to maintain pH of blood. Then secondary buffers that are present into the erythrocyte, which are oxyhemoglobin and hemoglobin, and acid or alkali, potassium salt or phosphoric acid. These are two systems which are working continuously to maintain pH of our blood 7.4. In pharmaceutical system, these buffers are also very important. In this field of pharmacy, as a ingredients in a most of pharmaceutical formulations, in order to adjust the pH of the product to that required for the maximal stability, particular substance is having a stability into the fixed pH range, either it is 2 to 4, 5 to 6. So we require to maintain that pH, then the substance will be stable for longer period of time. In parental preparation, in case pH should be considered carefully, as a large deviation of pH may lead to serious consequences. Means if there is a drastic change in the pH of your blood and pH of your formulation, they may lead to death of person also. In the ideal pH of parental product is 7.4, because pH of blood is 7.4, so your parental formulation should have 7.4 pH. Most commonly used buffer in this parental products are acetate buffers, phosphate buffers, citrate buffers and glutamate buffers, and that buffers are helpful to maintain pH of that parental formulation. Then in ophthalmic preparation also, we require to match a pH of our ophthalmic formulation with lacrimal secretion. Then buffer are generally used in ophthalmic formulation to maintain pH within the physiological pH of your lacrimal fluid, and lacrimal fluid is having a pH in between 7 to 8. It has a very good buffering capacity and can tolerate a pH value in between 3.5 to 10.5, along with the little discomfort, and outside this range increases lacrimation and may lead with other complication. Then buffering agents most commonly used in this ophthalmic formulation includes borate buffers, carbonate buffers and phosphate buffers. In ophthalmic ointment and creams also we require to maintain a pH. Then in topical products like ointments and creams also we require to maintain a pH of that formulation, which helpful to ensure stability of formulation. The most commonly used buffer in ointments and creams are citrate buffers and its salt, then phosphoric acid and its salt. Okay, this is all about buffer, buffer index, buffer mechanism and its application. Thank you for patient listening.